Llama 3.2 is finally out, and this time around, Meta is giving us something special. Unlike their previous models that only support text, these particular models now have vision capabilities. These models come in various versions. So in this tutorial, I'll be guiding you through how to set up this model for free so that you can use this model in your local development environment. Now, you don't have to pay for multimodal models from OpenAI anymore because these models are available and it's open source. You can just download it and use them locally or use a platform called Grok AI to get access to this model. I'll guide you through all the steps you need to follow to get this done. If you are ready to do this, let's get right into it. Alrighty, so before we get started, I want to give a quick shout out to all my patrons. I deeply appreciate your efforts to keep this content coming. So first of all, let's look at all the requirements for this particular tutorial. We only have two libraries here which we need to install. So if you are following this tutorial, make sure you install these two libraries, Grok and also python.env. And I'm going to show you how to install this just in a sec. Before that, you also need an image because we'll be testing the image capabilities of the Llama 3.2 model. So make sure you get some few images laying around. I'll show you using this particular image you are seeing on the screen. Also, go ahead and create your main.py file. And now you can see this file is empty. And lastly, also create .env file where we'll be putting our API key. So that's all the requirements you need. So now let's go ahead and install the libraries. So the command you need to type is pip install then -r and type the name requirement.txt. After this, hit enter, and this is going to install all the libraries in this requirement.txt file. In our case, Grok and also python.env. I've already installed this library, so all my requirements are satisfied, and that's what I was expecting. So I'll quickly close the terminal once again. And from here, the next step is to get the API key for Llama 3.2. So just go to console.grok.com and sign up. After signing up, you can come to the playground. I've done this several times in other tutorials, so it's pretty much the same step. And over here, you can see we have playground documentation, which you can also read some little documentation about their platform and also API keys. So right now, I'll just click on playground, and in the playground, you can see all the models here. So when you click here, you have a list of all the models they are currently hosting for you to use for free. The one we'll be using today will be Llama 3.2 Vision Preview. So we want to use the Vision based Llama 3.2. Already we can see we also have the test based one, but our focus is on the vision model. So just click on that model, and now that model is here. And you can even test this model on their platform. You can just click here, insert an image, and test the model. So it's pretty much the same thing you can do. You can enter a message, maybe tell me about this image. You can hit submit here, and after hitting submit, this should generate the response for you in no time. So the image shows a man wearing a green hoodie with a hood down. So that's it. This is how you can use it on their platform. But as developers, our main focus is on setting this up in our development environment. And in order to do that, we need an API key. So I'll click on the API key section, and I'll show you how to generate one of these API keys. All right, so you can see I've already generated some couple of API keys here. So if I want to generate again, I just have to create API key, and over here, you just have to give it a name. So this should be Llama 3.2, and I'll hit submit. This will go ahead and create the API key for me, and all I'll do is to copy it, and that's all. So we are done with the platform. Once you get an API key, you can head over back to your IDE and open your .env file, and you can see I have a sample API key here, which I'm already using. In your case, you can give it a name and paste that API key here. So over here, I can just call it key, and I'll paste this API key here. So it's like I have two, so I'll be using any of them will work. So that's fine. Okay, from here, I'll
close this .env file, close this image, close the requirement.txt file, and I'll just open the main.py file. I'll make sure I also close this for you guys to see better. We have to start off importing libraries, okay? So the libraries we'll be using, we have to go ahead and import them. And we'll be needing OS, so I'll import OS. From there, I'll also import the .env library. Finally, we have to import grok. So from grok, we are importing grok. Yeah, I think this is how you have to do it. Okay, the spelling here, grok t, no. But that should be from grok. We are importing grok. And finally, we also import base64. So we'll be using base64 to pre-process this image we'll be sending to the model. And guys, that's the very important step in this whole tutorial, how to process this image for the large language model to be able to use. So I'll import base64 for that case. Okay, so we are done with our imports, and from here we have to set up our API key, and the next step from there is to read in this image and pre-process it. Okay, so to set up our API key, you have to first of all load in all the environmental keys we are using. So for that, we'll use load.env, and with this particular line of code, we'll be able to load all API keys stored in the .env file. So it will load these two API keys, okay, but we are going to use only one of them. From here, what we'll do is to read in the key we will be using, and over here I have to type in the name of that particular API key I'll be using. So you can see in the .env file I have two API keys, so I just have to type the name of the one I'll be using, and I'll choose the first one, which is grok key. So inside here I'll just put this. So key is equal to os.get environmental key, and then I want to get the grok key. All right, from here we have to give the path to our image and continue to pre-process this image in order to feed this image into our model. So to do that, I'm going to first give the path to the image. I'm having this image in this same directory, so I can go ahead and copy the relative path and paste it right here. Okay, so this is the name of the image, so you have to do the same thing. If your image is on your desktop, make sure you just have to put the path leading to the image right here. So from here, let's go ahead and now pre-process this image. Okay, so we'll first read this image as byte. So we'll do with open, and then we are coming to open the image path, and we are reading it as byte. Okay, so we are reading it as image file, and from here we'll have to get the byte image. So we'll call this byte image, and byte image is equal to image file dot read. Right after reading this image file, this is where the base64 library is going to shine. We'll use the base64 library to encode this image. Okay, so to, in other words, to pre-process this image. So from here I'll just call this encoded image, and this is equal to base64.base64 encode, and inside here we give it our byte image. And we are not done. After encoding, we also decode it, and we'll decode it as UTF-8, not as, this is all we need to do for our image to be pre-processed. So from here now we have successfully pre-process our image. So the next thing now is to send this image to our large language model, and we can now give it a prompt as to what it should do about this image. So for that, let's go back to Grok AI platform, and there I'll show you how to get that particular code. So we are going back to the playground, and in the playground here you can see view code. Okay, so over here we can copy the code and also change the model. So before you copy this code, you can first change the model before copying the code, so that that model will be inserted by default. So I'll just come ahead and choose the vision preview model, and now when I go back to view code, you can see I have the vision preview model right here, and I can go ahead now and copy this particular code, and back here I have to paste the code. So this is the code we'll be using, and we've already imported grok, so I can get rid of this. All right, over here you have to first insert in your API key so that you can communicate with the models that have been hosted on that particular platform. So inside this parenthesis, just type API key, and this should be equal to our key we've read. Okay, so the API key is equal to the key we've read, and that's the setup you need to do. From here, now we need to insert our image. Okay, so we need to find a way to modify this so that it takes an image. And that's what I've done. So I'll just copy that code and paste it out for you guys so that you can actually work with this. It's pretty much the same code. If you have glanced through it, you can see it's pretty much the same code. But what I've done is to add the ability for us to add images. So you can see now we have type here, which is image URL, and we are sending it the image. So we are sending it our encoded image, and right here we have that encoded image. So that's all you need to do. And over here at text, this is what you instruct the model to do concerning the image. So you can ask it, okay, what is in the image? What should it do about this image? And that's the answer it's going to give you. We have some hyperparameters here you can also play with. So stream is false, stop is none. So if you don't need them, you can even get rid of them entirely, or you can enter some values to see how it performs. So this is all we need to do, and from here what I'll do is to run this code so that we see how well it will perform. Okay, so here we go. So you can see this has returned as our chat completion message, and the content it has returned here is that the image appears to be a photograph of a driver's side of a maroon SUV. Okay, I think that's correct, parked on an auto mechanic lot. You can see the car's rear passenger door and so on. So it has accurately told us whatever it has seen in an image, and I think this model is performing very well. So let's not say this model is an open source model, so it's not performing well. I've actually tested this model ton of time, and it came out very good, giving me a very good result. So it's a good model, and what is great about it is that you can fine tune this model for free and also use it for free. So this is how easy you can test this model in code, and you can set it up and get it up and running. If you like this tutorial, don't forget to give me a thumbs up, and also the code for this tutorial will be on my GitHub repository so that you guys can set up this quick and also play with it. Let me know in the comment section what you guys want next and projects you think we should build with this model. I love the vision capabilities, and I can't get to hear from you guys on what next we should build. So once again, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next tutorial.